so now we have to study how to draw all the degrees of elasticity on a single diagram. First mark ED equal to 0 and ED equal to infinity, the two extreme degrees. Then through the center you will mark ED equal to 1, right? Then between ED equal to 1 and ED equal to 0, another line. Okay, see, now this line lies between 0 and 1. So it is ED greater than 0, less than 1, right? Similarly, another line, straight line between infinity and 1. So this is ED greater than 1, less than infinity. So all the degrees of elasticity can be shown on a single diagram, right? Remember the steps. First you draw the two extreme degrees, then you draw the center one, ED equal to 1, bisected, and you will get the other two degrees, right? Now, after understanding all the degrees of elasticity, we have to understand how to measure the elasticity or how to calculate the elasticity. Methods of calculating elasticity of demand. We have three methods. First is the percentage method. Or also known as the proportionate method. Second is the total outlay method. And third is the point method. So these are the three methods: percentage method, also known as the proportionate method, total outlay method, also known as the total expenditure method, and the point method or the geometric method. You can draw together, bhai. We have different ways of calculating the elasticity under all these methods, but few things before going into the details of these methods. First of all, you have to remember one thing, you have to notice one thing, that if you use the percentage or proportionate method, the answer will be a exact value between 0 and infinity. Okay, it can be any value, like for example ED equal to 1 or 2 or maybe 0.5 or 0.75. When you use the total outlay method, you will have only three answers. Okay, if you use the total expenditure method in a particular numerical, answer could be only three. Here it is in comparison to unity, either equal to 1 or greater than 1 or less than 1. Under the geometric method, you do not have any numerical. We just have diagrammatic representation. Okay, so these are the basic things that you have to remember about the methods of calculating the elasticity of demand, right? So now we'll be studying the total outlay method, the first method, the percentage method or the proportionate method. Okay, percentage method or the proportionate method. Under this method we use the formula percentage change in quantity demanded अपॉन परसेंटेज चेंज इन प्राइस, राइट? सिंपली वी आर कंपेयरिंग द चेंज इन क्वांटिटी एंड चेंज इन प्राइस, सो वी कैन कम टू नो हाउ मच डिमांड इज रिस्पोंडिंग इन टर्म्स ऑफ द चेंजेस इन प्राइस, एंड वी आर यूजिंग परसेंटेज टू मेक देम इन इक्वल यूनिट्स, राइट? लाइक आई हैव टोल्ड यू बिफोर ऑल्सो दैट क्वांटिटी डिमांडेड इज इन द यूनिट्स एंड प्राइस इज इन रुपीज, सो टू मेक द कॉमन यूनिट वी कन्वर्ट देम इनटू परसेंटेज. Now we have to understand what does this mean, the percentage change in quantity demanded and percentage change in quantity, percentage change in price. Take an example, must have done many questions in class 8, 9, 6, 7, 8, right, where you get a question that the population of a town was 10,000 in a certain year, say in 2000, okay, while in 2005 the population was say 12,000, right? So calculate the percentage change in population. How did you used to do it? 12,000 minus 10,000, 2,000 upon the original population multiplied by 100. It means it is nothing new, you have already done it, you just have to convert it into percentage change in price or quantity. So simply the change in Q upon the original Q multiplied by 100, okay? First you find out by how much the quantity is changing, right? And then you divide it by the original quantity. Remember this example, done it 100 of times, right? Similarly, percentage change in price is, so percentage change in quantity is change in Q upon Q into 100. And applying the same logic, percentage change in prices delta P by P into 100, right? And overall when you convert them, divide them, you will get the elasticity. Now this particular formula can be used to derive another formula in terms of units. Now we will see the derivation of that particular formula, how it is derived. Let's say original quantity is Q and say original price is P, new and the new quantity is Q1 and price is P1. Now these are two quantities, maybe say in one month it is this much and second month it is this much, or when the price comes from this to this, then how it is changing, right? Now change in Q. Change in Q is Q minus Q1 or Q1 minus Q, whichever is bigger. Okay? Change can be calculated, can be denoted by delta Q, right? Similarly, change in price is P minus P1 or P1 minus P, whichever is bigger, you subtract the smaller from one from it, and can be denoted by delta P. Okay? Then the percentage change in quantity is delta Q upon Q into 100. Same formula, change in the quantity upon original quantity into 100, right? And percentage change in price is delta P upon P into 100. Now see, look at the formula of ED, percentage change in quantity upon percentage change in price, means this divided by this. If you name it as 1, name it as 2, 1 divided by 2, right? So it means delta Q upon Q into 100 upon delta P upon P into 100. So 100 will get cancelled. Now I have delta Q upon Q divided by delta P upon P, right? No, already you have done it so many times. Division sign change into multiplication sign, what will happen? Denominator becomes a numerator and numerator becomes a denominator, or you can say reciprocal. So it will become P upon delta P. Right? To make my formula look little better, I can write it as delta Q by delta P into P by Q. Just bringing both the deltas together doesn't make a difference. 3 into 5 or 5 into 3 doesn't make a difference. Right? Same thing. I can shift them. Okay, so I have two formulas under the percentage method. One formula, the first formula is this, the basic formula. From this formula, I have derived one more formula. This one I have to use where everything is given in units. Okay, where suppose it is given that when the price of a commodity was rupees 10, consumer was buying say 15 units. When the price fell to 8, consumer started buying 20 units. So it means everything is given in units. This formula is easy to apply, right? Well, this one is needed where one particular variable is given in percentage. Like it is saying that price fell from 10 to 8 and the demand changed by 20%. So it means one is already in percent, another one should be converted into percent, right? By applying this formula, either this or this, and then you can use the basic formula, right? For these you have to practice the numericals. Then the second method that we have to study is the total outlay method. Or the total expenditure method. Okay, now remember that in the beginning I told you that when you use the percentage method, you can get any mathematical answer, any value, numerable, a number. But when you use a total outlay method, you get only three answers, either ED equal to 1 or ED less than 1 or ED greater than 1. Before moving on, first we have to understand what is this total outlay. It is nothing, it is total expenditure. Suppose you went to a market to buy a biscuit, packet of biscuit which is priced at 5 and you wanted to buy 3 units of that particular biscuit. How much money you need to spend? That is 15 rupees. That is your expenditure on the particular commodity. Simple, P into Q. Total expenditure, or you also call it as the total outlay, is equal to P into Q. And it can be defined as a total expenditure done by a consumer on a given commodity. Okay, now we know the meaning of total outlay. Now how to go further in this method? This method is simply based on the relation between the total outlay and the price. Right? You have to find out what relation is there between total outlay and price. For that, what you need to do is, the first step is you calculate total outlay and total outlay 1. Where total outlay means the outlay at, or the total expenditure at, the original price and quantity. Right? Why total outlay 1 means the total outlay at the new price and new quantity, or we denote them as P1 and Q1. Right? So P1 into Q1 is equal to total outlay 1, TO1, and P into Q is equal to total outlay. That is the original total outlay. Now after calculating these two total outlay, just compare. Total outlay, either it would be rising or it would be falling, or it may remain same. Right? Like when you calculated the first total outlay, suppose it was coming 20 and the second one is coming as 25. So it means total outlay is rising. If the first one is coming 20 and second one is coming 15, it means total outlay is falling. So you have to just see that what is happening to the total outlay. Then similarly, you see what is happening to the price. price would also be either rising or falling. It won't be constant, right? Because if price is constant, then no elasticity cannot be calculated. Price has to change. So now if total outlay and price, now you, after understanding this concept, you have to just remember that what step has to be taken, and remember quantity need not be seen. Quantity is not to be seen. Only what I have, it is based on what? Only between the relation between total outlay and the price. So now after calculating the total outlay and the price and seeing that at the movement direction of the price, you have to remember that it is based on the total outlay and relation between total outlay and price, and after seeing the movement in the direction of the price, you can have three possibilities. The first case, that total outlay and price may be inversely related. Means moving in the opposite direction. If one is rising, another one is falling, right? And how to see if you get confused in all these, just make arrows. Total outlay, make the arrow. Suppose it is rising upwards. Price, suppose it is falling downwards. Okay, inverse relation, opposite direction. Or it could be total outlay falling and price rising. Then also it is inverse, opposite direction, right? If this is the case, this is what you observe, it means that your EDA is greater than 1. This is your answer. ED more than 1. And along with that, you will also have to mention in a statement, because total outlay and price are inversely related, right? This is the case 1, or the first answer, first possibility. Then the second possibility is just opposite. Case 2, when total outlay and price are directly means moving in the same direction. Again, if I make the arrows, I observe both arrows are in the same direction. If total outlay is rising, price is also rising, and if total outlay is falling, price is also falling, inversely directly related. In that case, your answer is ED less than 1. This is your answer to that scenario, right? And again, you have to mention that because they both are directly related, thus ED is less than 1. Then another possibility, the third possibility, under which we said that total outlay remains constant. Suppose before change in price, it was 70, and after change in price also it is 70. Like for example, if a consumer was buying a commodity 8 units at price of 7, and he buys 7 units at the price of 8, in both cases it will be 56, right? So in that case, ED is equal to 1. Okay? Perfect response, right? Expenditure of the consumer doesn't change. So again, you can see that it is, if you go into a little understanding of the method, it is simply saying that if the consumer can change his total outlay with the change in price, so it means the demand is elastic, right? But if he cannot change his expenditure, it means the demand is inelastic. Okay, then this method can be diagrammatically represented. On the x-axis you take the total outlay or the total expenditure, while on the y-axis you take the price. Simple to draw. Upward sloping line, straight line, downward sloping line, right? Upward sloping line, you already know that it shows me the direct relation, right? So on the direct relation, ED was less than 1, right? Here total outlay remains unchanged, so ED is equal to 1, and here ED is greater than 1. If you have any problem in understanding it, I'll simply make it easier for you. Suppose you are on point A on this particular line. So if you move on to point B, both are increasing. Price, total outlay is also increasing and price is also increasing. Similarly, if you draw a point C here, then this is your price and this is your total outlay. Even if you move to point D, price may change but total outlay remains the same. While on this line, if you are say on point E, this is your price, this is the total outlay. You move on to point F, when you move on to point F, price falls and total outlay rises. Okay, so this is the explanation. When you draw in your exam, in your test, need not mark the points, simply draw the diagram. This is for your understanding, right? This is how it can be explained. And then the third method is the geometric method or the point method. Under this particular method, as I told you that it is only in the diagrammatic, only there is only a diagrammatic representation, no numericals, right? First assumption is that here the demand curve is assumed to be a linear curve. Linear simply means a straight line. Right? Demand curve won't be a curve, it would be a straight line, linear curve. Linear, those of you remember this term, linear means on lying on the same line, right? Straight line. Then second thing, the formula for elasticity is lower segment This is the formula for calculating the elasticity at any point. Right? It is a straight line. Okay? And if you want to find the elasticity at any point, this is the formula. Suppose this point is say point P, lower segment, and this is the upper segment. Right? We'll do it diagrammatically, you can understand it better. Like say this is my demand curve, linear demand curve. Linear means that it is a straight line. Here again you have the quantity demanded, here you have the price. Mark points on this curve, A, B, C, D and E. Okay, now suppose the formula was ED is equal to lower segment of the curve upon upper segment, right? At point A, this, so if I want to calculate ED at point A, so again the same formula, lower segment, there is nothing below point A, so it is 0. Upper segment is AE, so any 0 divided by anything is 0, right? So it means that at point A, ED is equal to 0. At point B, lower segment is BA, the lower part of the line, and upper segment is BE. So again you can observe that here BA is a smaller segment and BE is a larger segment. Smaller number divided by a larger number, answer is always less than 1, 0 point something, right? Similarly at point C, it is CA upon CE. So now you can see that both segments are equal. So same number divided by itself will give you result as 1. And at point D, lower segment is DA, upper segment is DE. So again you can see now a bigger number divided by a smaller number, answer will be at least 1 point something. Point E, lower segment is EA, upper segment is 0. Anything divided by 0 is equal to infinity, right? So here ED is equal to 0 at point A, then ED greater than, sorry, ED less than 1 but greater than 0, the second degree, then the third degree, ED equal to 1 at point E, ed more than 1 but less than infinity at point e, ed equals to infinity, right? So if a question is asked regarding the geometric method, you have to first tell the first assumption that a Demard curve is assumed to be a straight line. Second, you have to tell the formula that elasticity at any point is equal to lower segment upon the upper segment, and after that this diagrammatic representation and similar working, then you will be able to score the full marks in this particular question. It can be asked in 4 mark question. We now, after understanding the methods of the calculating elasticity and the meaning of elasticity, now one more important topic is there, which is the relation between slope of Demard curve and elasticity of Demard. Right now, elasticity, we already know what elasticity is. We have to understand what is the slope of a Demard curve. We already know that slope of any curve is equal to delta y upon delta x. Right? This is a formula for calculating slope of any curve. If you talk about the Demard curve, on the y-axis I have price and on the x-axis I have quantity. Right? So it means slope of the Demard curve is equal to delta p by delta q. Now what is ED? ED is equal to delta q by delta p into p by q. Right? This formula we have already done. Now take this as your first equation. Just see, here it is delta q by delta p and here it is delta p by delta q. So it means that if I reciprocal it, so I can write it as, it is what? It is the slope of the Demard curve. So I can write it as 1 upon slope is equal to delta q by delta p. Okay? Do the reciprocal on both the sides. Here also and here also. If you are getting confused, you can simply write it like this. Slope is equal to delta p by delta q. So 1 upon slope is equal to delta q by delta p. Now you just have to put this equation here in this formula. So it becomes ed is equal to 1 upon slope into p by q. Means suppose the slope of the Demard curve is given to you. Then you can simply add 1 by slope into the given price and the given quantity and you will get the value of your ED. And theoretically also you understand that there is a inverse relation between slope of the Demard curve and elasticity of